guys, my name is Rybro, and welcome to Life is Strange Before the Storm. Now, this is a game that I've been waiting for a while, like I've been waiting forever, almost as long as Mother 4. Well, actually, not really. But this game has been in my favorites for, like, forever, and it's kind of in, like I love the Life is Strange universe. It's kind of like 13 Reasons Why, kind of in like that everything is like happening to people and you get like emotionally like attached to people and you get behind the story and all that. And I basically just binge watched it, and I actually watched it right over there. I remember bringing up my bed and like just like sitting like that and just watching Jacksepticeye play it. And now I can't wait to play it for myself, because I'm actually wrapped up in a blanket right now, right here. I'm so excited to play this, and I'm in love with the soundtrack. I listen to it whenever I'm, I don't know, just chilling, just like rearranging stuff, moving my setup or anything like that. So I don't really know what else to say, but hopefully, if you'll let me comments, if I'll be able to maybe spam this just a little bit, because I am leaving tomorrow with to Barry with my family. I'm going ziplining and all that, and I'm really excited about that, but I'm actually kind of more excited about this, honestly. But I can't wait to go ziplining, and that's why I'm like preparing videos, and this came out at the perfect date. So this is going way back before Chloe dyed her hair blue. We might even see that in this game, and learn about her. So I don't really know how this is gonna go. I said I was like a bit worried before, but I don't know. It's a Life is Strange game, so I'm probably gonna love it either-wise. Okay. Illegal. Well, maybe not illegal. Does that train know you're there? Do you know the train's there? Can't stop it with your smoke. 1337. Can I do anything? It's trying to stop. You're just trying to wreck everyone's day. Hop and a hop. And then she'll look the other way and the hood will go up. Oh. That is Chloe. Okay, I thought it was Max for a second.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
Yeah, Firewalk.
My mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
I'm so excited. Yeah. 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 Different camera angles. Okay. Fence. Guess we can't go to the old mill. I want to read the warning first, maybe.
No trespassing? No way.
Everyone else did. Don't touch it.
Holy shit.
Squeak. Purple. Red.
This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
And I'll have to get through that man. Bouncer.
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
I'm just looking at him weird.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Aw. You threw it at me. That hurt.
Can't let him push me around.
Back to our challenge.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
In backtalk, you use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want. Whoa.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Your bedtime?
Aww. Isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Cute. I don't do cute.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
I'm not cute.
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
I don't need you. Girl like me?
You mean a girl who doesn't take shit from a walking pair of biceps like you? That kind of girl?
My boss will kill me if I let you in.
Bosses suck.
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid.
Yeah! Don't look at my ass. Okay, thank you. I got in the old mill. Proud of me, Mom? Well, actually, no. She's not supposed to know. Okay. Am I going to have to use back talk? Well, also, I forgot
this
to mention,
is intense.
Life is Strange has...
Hey, Delia, come.
Cute dog.
I forgot to mention the... Whoa. The writing is a little bit... Scream, don't touch my soul with your dirty hand. Question everything. Why? Pastime beer. Okay, never mind. I'll just look at this.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
Yeah. Okay. The writing in this game is kind of questionable because it's adults writing what they think we sound like teenagers. So I don't know. Fuck off. I don't know. But like when I was watching Jacksepticeye play it, the writing was kind of. It was bad, but it was funny, so I don't mean to... Okay, follow the... Whoa.
Classy. Sketch Central.
Saw blade.
Graffiti everywhere. I think they missed a spot.
Should I graffiti in here? Whoa! I thought he just hit his head off a wall. Push through.
Damn, there are a lot of people here.
And everyone's pushing. They won't mind if I do,
here
right?
Here
we go. Wah! Oh god.
Fuck.
Hey.
I'm sorry.
You okay?
I'm fine.
Bumped into me, remember?
Pull him off.
Fuck off, man.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
No, and I don't want to.
No. And I give zero shits.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine.
Ah.
Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
Yes. And we won't fall.
Hey.
That's the guy that I may or may not have killed his dog.
Name, you idiot.
I think.
Pot for me every month for a year.
Okay. Dicey stairs. They're still walking up. Are they over? Is it over? Don't fall through them. Is there a reason why no one's up here?
Yes! Finally made it! I can't believe it!
That's a pretty good view. Well, watch where you're dancing. That kind of looks like Monica from Friends. I don't want to leave. You see this character having fun? You see her having fun? Saw Blade. I'd do that, but I'm standing up. Actually, don't mind the music. This is way better than doing drugs. Oh, God.
You spilled my beer, bitch.
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Try and walk away.
We're not done.
Come on.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's the guy's calling like, us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you.
Now watch where you're going.
Hey, dickhead.
I like how he looked. Ah! Oh ho ho.
Rachel? Come on.
I'm going with Rachel.
Hurry up.
Not gonna happen. Calm down.
Come on, man.
Walk away.
Screw this.
I love Frank.
Bullshit the fuck out of here.
Bullshit the fuck out of here. Whoa! Okay. Is that like a mug? With like fire coming out of it? So many people there. That was stressful. Class. Hi, Square Enix. And also, I really want to know how this all ties into, like, the... Because this is a prequel. Before everything happened. Before the storm.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell.
I think I know that song.
Rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Let's read about Max. Max Caulfield. So, are we not friends now? Then my dad died, and her dad got some job up north, and she moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment when I needed her most, and she bailed. Thanks, Max, for teaching me that I can't rely on anyone. I mean it. Life lesson learned.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live, the skeevy assholes, that girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? Smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Okay. Okay. Can't do it that fast. Mr. Sharky. Beanbag chair.
Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town.
Yeah.
Wait, what? Who? What photo? I have feelings about this.
Oh.
Most of them are not good feelings.
Hmm. Okay. I don't know which, like, what's gonna be really important to read and what's not. Because I'll feel bad if I miss stuff. Okay, I thought it said get depressed. Yeah. Let's get dressed. What are we going to wear? Butterfly. Ooh, butterfly. Bonus outfits. Classic Chloe pre-order. Yeah, sure. Okay. Okay,
really should get going.
Okay. I thought the music should stop
Mom
for a second.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome.
Alright, let's go have some breakfast. Fantasy poster. Okay. Okay, Mr. Sharky, you want some
Fun
attention.
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
But you're not a shark, you silly.
There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Why is it there? Just text everyone. No, I am having breakfast with my mom. Can't? Mom, will you be coming home at some point tonight? Will you be coming home by curfew? There will be consequences. No breakfast? Elliot? Okay, I can go up. Can I? Spanish test sucked. Lucky if I passed. Aw, lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Cool. What you up to? Not much, just shit to do later. Oh, okay. You finished chemistry homework? Nope. Dude, that's the third time. I already know everything.
Chloe, right. Breakfast! Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
Alright.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Where's purse? Purse.
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
That was a lot of ice cream. Okay. Where's her purse? Purse. There's a ring. Oh, purse! Take. Yeah.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too?
Ah.
No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
It's like she knows every time I collected something.
That really makes me want to hurry.
Fall down the stairs. Oh, okay.
Coming, Mom.
Stomp.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Okay. Like that, like just cheesy lines like that. What's this?
Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
Well, you should have your own. Place.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what okay. Mom wants before she strokes out.
No, I think that's just the toast burning. But, okay.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately.
It was the doorknob.
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Okay.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Let's talk about school.
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
Was it sand in the microwave?
I used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
Let's talk about David
you
then.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that?
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship.
Blackwell.
Remember. Money's tight enough as it is.
Yeah. Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Be understanding.
Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient.
What happened if I said what I felt?
But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too. Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
It's fine. What's it say on the microwave? Love you, Mom. Oh.
It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Oh, yeah. She did work in a diner.
Snow dough.
Feeling trapped? Right there with you.
Can I shake it? I want to shake it.
Little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
Okay. Take keys. Okay. Yeah.
Let's get these to David so he can drive away.
This will defend.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going. Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max? And never looked back?
She'll come back. The right things will happen. Eventually. If it's meant to be, it'll happen. Okay, let's get in the car. Okay. Hey, is this Chloe? This is Steph Gingrich. Hey, I have your DVD. You can get it before school. Thanks. Okay. Now I have a reason to go in his car. Hi, bird.
What a piece of crap. The car, and too.
I was gonna say.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination.
Dark purple.
No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electro insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get...
What's happening?
What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something?
That's not good.
Do they even make film for these anymore?
I don't know. Did the guy that make it, is he even around anymore? Wait, what is it written on my hand? Tick.
50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40.
Maybe 90-10. Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay.
I kind of forget how bad he was from the last game. Socket wrench.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you.
Come on, let's fix your car with the hustle.
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign
carbon
of carbon
deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Yeah, sure.
Fine. Whatever.
I want to be a nice person.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I want to talk to you about something.
Fuck!
Ah!
You don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Shut this down. Yeah, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce! Your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me?
No.
Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
Put headphones in. Listen to music.
Country music. Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you.
What is this? Is this a dream?
What a beautiful day.
Socket Ranch, glad to see you again.
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad.
Oh, that ice cream magazine.
I guess Mom left her purse back here.
Store. I remember that. When Max was trying to stop time from them going to the grocery store. And you tried everything you could to try and stop them from going.
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying...
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Let's go to school. Black Hell. The Tempest. Drugs that will mess you up. Good luck, seniors. My butterfly. Future needs excellence. That is true.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? No. This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
Maybe?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck,
right?
Hey.
That's what I was thinking.
I was a drama kid.
See you and Cam.
Yeah, for sure.
I didn't do my homework. I don't want to go to chemistry. Press and hold to
gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD.
Okay. Ah! Hey, I'm at the picnic tables with Mikey. Thanks. Picnic tables. Okay. That's Victoria. Hi!
Ah, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
Oh, yeah.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, yeah, it's hard teacher. To keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever.
Mark Jefferson.
But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Rachel Amber.
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
We murdered a man.
Tell what, Victoria? It's a photo. Big deal.
But it's on Facebook. I mean, that basically means you and Rachel are like BFFs.
We're really not.
But it's
so
on Facebook.
What's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit.
Well, I
you
do
know,
call myself a drug
I mean,
sometime.
Look at your face.
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
I'm just came in my
Well, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh.
Sabotage your homework.
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude.
Maybe.
You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Of course.
I didn't!
That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, and uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey, Thanks, Carrie.
Oh, no, I feel bad. I know you were all looking at her ass. I was too. Don't worry about it. okay. Picnic tables. Where are the picnic tables? Sign. Do not walk on the stage. Should I walk on the stage?
Weirdly, that makes me interested in walking on the stage.
Looking very closely at it. Miss Grant. Oh, I remember. She's science teacher? Is she? Or, and then there was another creepy guy. There was a creepy teacher. Steph.
I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
Yeah, and I'm nerding it up with Miss Grant right now.
Morning, Miss Grant.
Chloe, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today.
Highly probable. I don't want to ruin the mystery.
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad.
I'm sorry. Things will turn around.
Maybe in another 6 months, a new donor will come along with money for, I don't know, more lasers.
More lasers?
Do we have any lasers?
Sadly, no.
That is
sadly,
sad.
No. So she does want lasers. Okay. Okay, picnic tables. Hey! We're here. Is that them? Yeah.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Try me.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Tabletop cool. Simulator.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner, director's cut, coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Yeah.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just, like, a friend thing?
Rachel Amber? I don't want to be mean, but...
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Shut up, you're just
Chloe,
depressed that you couldn't
you
use your...
game.
Thing.
I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
Sure.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Shut up! You're just depressed because you couldn't use your thing. I'm totally
nice.
An elf barbarian.
I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know. I'm good. All right, let's get started. You were both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron.
Doctor.
Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamah, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
Barbara. Oh. Barb! Yeah!
Barb.
No. Steph.
Hey, give Barb a chance, okay?
Give Barb a chance. You're just depressed because you couldn't use your thing.
Hold on. Elamah narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
According to your character sheet. A man kebab. Aw, oh, they're both good. I once made a man kebab.
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him too. True story.
That's what Barb did.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durg.
Elamah frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Duty.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Training ground, prison camp, leave the game. I don't want to leave the game. They're all like, training ground.
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Okay, I'll listen to you.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Oh, is that good?
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing.
And more pointing.
Pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Fatal cleave, knee slam, pommel strike. Is that like French for throwing apples? Because palm is French for apple.
I do a pommel strike. I strike his pommel. What did I say?
A pommel is the end of a sword handle. Pommel strike is where you hit the guy with it.
I know.
Okay, I do that.
Except you're not wielding a sword, you're wielding an axe.
This sucks!
It's alright. Try using your...
You've delayed too long. The orc swings
no!
the warhammer at your head, barely missing. Your
stupid
move.
Delays! Fatal.
Okay, let's end this.
I would have
fatal
used a knee
cleave.
One.
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game.
It's going well.
Yeah, and then we roast him on the fire.
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid...
Okay, never mind.
It's unlikely any loot survived.
Ah! Yeah, that's why... Why'd you use the acid? We needed the loot. We all make mistakes. You'll pay for this. We all make mistakes.
Don't worry, Elamah guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamah, nice. Barb, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
What's next?
Okay. I'm having fun with this. I was supposed to go... Well, actually, I was just supposed to get my tape, but I'm having fun with this. let's go to prison
guess
camp.
It's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
Yeah, and let's not step on some acid on the way there.
You will hold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes.
What about a witchkin?
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops no up voices. And down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Intimidate. Pick the lock, tempt with bread.
Apparently, I have bread. I try to tempt the little bastard out with it.
He sticks out his tongue, finding your offering disgusting.
It's bread! Intimidate.
Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen Please? Up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't...
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
I cast
now
communication.
Every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use...
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Dragons are pussies. Meat puppet, shoes. Dragons are
pussies. Everybody knows that dragons are pussies. That's why they hide in caves and only come out to breathe fire on sheep and eat cows and shit. This tabletop shit is hard.
Try playing solo.
The dragonkin swallows the key, pointing at his stomach and then his own butt, laughing at you. Then he...
I shove my axe through the cage, right into his stomach. Then I twist it, and then pull it out. His guts and shit start falling everywhere, but I jam my hands inside his open stomach, grabbing the key. Then, in the final moments before he dies, I hold the key up to his face, and then I laugh.
Normally, I'd say you failed the challenge, except that was so horrifically amazing. You won.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
Wardlord's tent! Yeah, and the cool story bro guy will cast communication on all the prisoners.
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long.
Well, I'm swathed in a golden blanket.
Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing.
Nice voice
break. Your
kingdom
was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The cone fire fizzles out on contact.
Go cones.
Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. It tells time.
All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast. Which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe.
It's okay. Barb.
What'll it be?
Annihilation strike, brutal punch, wrathful rush. Wrathful rush.
What's wrathful rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry shoulder slam.
I have broad shoulders, so that works.
I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
Plus one damage. Brutal punch.
I want to punch that stupid man cow in the dick.
Like, right in the dick?
Right in the dick.
You miss. Dorian burst out laughing as you stumble past.
I got his inner thigh.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage. Ouch.
But I only have 10.
What do you do next?
The last thing to do.
Oh, holy shit. Annihilation strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
1?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, 3.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
I'm sorry.
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
Go back in time and listen to Phoebe! dance? Jump in front of him. Okay, so he only has fire-based elements. He only has fire-based attacks.
Jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Bob.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Oh.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Good thing there's no, like, cutscenes.
I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
Scream for mom. Swing for his arm. Swing for his head.
I take one last swing at Durface's head.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Oh no.
11. You swing, catching Durgaron on the side of his head, severing one horn, but you don't do enough damage to kill him.
Asshole!
He laughs.
I like how she tells the story.
Rips you off his sword with a vicious jerk. You die
like,
painfully.
She decides.
So mean.
I'm sorry, Chloe. I have to escape.
Hey, man. If you can, do it.
I cast Warden's Hideaway.
You sure?
Hiding
That's
in a hole.
That's all I've got.
You summon a spectral door, which shields you from Durgaron. Light flares out, blinding him. The door swings shut, then disappears. You are gone from sight and cannot be harmed.
Yay!
I guess
we'll try tomorrow.
I'll have to come back when I'm stronger.
And have legs again. How long have we been playing that?
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Oh. That's awesome. Like, I was just like scribbles.
Sorry I died and left you out there to fend for yourself.
It's cool. I'll get him. Eventually.
Yeah. Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see.
It reminds me of John.
Thanks for the game, nerds.
How long have I been playing that?
Check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
Yeah. In the middle of all that, I was going to be like, oh, you, how about Miss Grant joins, and she can kill everyone with lasers. Okay, I'm going to leave my episode here. This was awesome. I'm going to end it. They're still playing without me? Well, at least I got my tape. I don't know how long I played for that. but that was really fun. I know I didn't do much except that. But I think I've been recording long enough for first episode, so...
If I'm late to class, that's just one more excuse for Mom to sick David on me.
Okay, then we'll pause it. So if they give me that for the first episode, I can't wait to see what they give me for the next ones. So, thank you all so much for watching. Share with a friend. And I hope to see you in the next one. So, bye for now. Rybro out.